In last slide, we discussed about Hermite curve representation. These are all the curves related for synthetic curves representation. Okay, these are all related to synthetic curves, like Hermite cubic spline, B spline, next Bezier curve. First of all, I am discussing about Hermite curve. Hermite curve definition is the curve that is designed by using two control points and one tangent segment. Here, two control points, those are u equal to 0 at initial point P0 and u equal to 1 at another point P1. First of all, initially, three control points are there: P0, P1, P1 dash. After that, the adding of one tangent segment, that is converted 3 into 4. So for that reason, I'm writing here 3 multiplied with 4, that equal to 12. 12 coefficients are to be determined. 0 less than or equal to u, u less than or equal to 1. That is the condition we are using here for representation in matrix form. P of u equal to x of u comma y of u comma z of u transpose. In this, for matrix representation, I am taking three-dimensional coordinate system here. For that reason, I am taking x, y, z here. First of all, x of u equal to, I am writing in parametric here. C3x u cube plus C2x u square plus C1x u plus C0x. Okay. Similarly, y of u, the changing of equation from x of u to z of u, that will be in coordinate points. That means x, y, z. Those points are only changes from equation to equation, from x of u to z of u. Remaining equation will be same for all equations. Okay. Next, P of u equal to x of u, y of u, z of u transpose. That will be written in sigma I of 0 to 3, Ci ui. That means summation of all C terms, coefficients with u terms, x of u, y of u, z of u equations. That will be written in sigma of I equal to 0 to 3, Ci ui. Taken u as common, u cube, u square, u 1. The remaining will be in matrix form C3, C2, C1, C0. That equal to u transpose and C. Next. In this, I am showing different types of Hermite curves here. Finally, we'll find 12 coefficients by using Hermite curve representations, 12 coefficients to be determined. In x direction, I am taking x of u, in y direction, y of u. After that, writing of sigma I equal to 0 to 3, Ci ui. That equation will be written in polynomial form. This is a polynomial equation, C3 u cube plus C2 u square plus C1 u1 plus C0. It will be written P of P equal to 3 C3 u square plus 2 C2 u plus C1. That is boundary condition because of location of the two endpoints and their two slopes. at two endpoints. In previous slide, I was told to you, Hermite curve consists of two control points. One is u equal to 0 and u equal to 1. Because of that, two endpoints or two control points, I am writing at p naught equal to c naught, p naught dash equal to c1, p1 equal to adding of all c terms, coefficient c3, c2, c1 until c0. Next, p1 dash equal to 3c3 plus 2c2 plus c1. Next, in c terms, c0 equal to p0, c1 equal to p0 dash, c2 equal to 3 of p1 minus p0 minus 2p0 dash minus p1 dash. These are all terms are important for finding of 12 coefficients here. The final equation will be p factor that equal to sigma of I equal to 0 to 3 ci ui. This is a polynomial equation c3 u cube plus c2 u square plus c1 u1 plus c0. All parameters can be determined. 12 parameters are determined here. That is the very important equation of Hermite curve representation in polynomial form. In matrix form, it will be u cube, u square, u1, u and 1. The terms in top side, I'm representing here p of u equal to 2u cube minus 3u square plus 1. And taking commons of p's here, p0, p1, p0 dash, p1 as commons here. The remaining terms will be written in matrix form 2 minus 2, 1, 1. It will be in taking of p0 in common side. Remaining terms will be 2 minus 3, 1 here. 2 minus 3, 0, 1 in p0. Next, minus 2, 3, 0, 0 in p1. In p0 dash, minus 2, 1, 0. In p1 dash 1 minus 1 0 0 that will be in matrix form, where here MH is the Hermite matrix, V is the geometry of vector. Next, properties of Hermite curve. Hermite curve is a composed of linear combination of the tangents and locations. Because of here, first of all, I'm taking one tangent from initial point p0. So for that reason, I'm telling that it is a composed of linear combination of tangents and locations. That means location of two endpoints u equal to 0 and u equal to 1. Tangent is the starting point from p0 point u equal to 0. Alternatively, the curve is a linear combination of Hermite and basic function matrix M. Next, disadvantages of Hermite curve. Requires the specification of the tangents because of it is a combination of linear curves and tangents. This information is not always available because of including tangents in Hermite curves. Limited to third degree polynomial, therefore curve is quite stiff. No blendings here. The curve is strictly stiff. Next comes to Bezier curve. Bezier curve is obtained by defining a polygon. Here I am showing the difference of Bezier curve over Hermite cubic spline. First of all, Bezier curve is based on defining of a polygons here. Here, P0, P1, P2, P3. P0, P3 is the first and last points. Those are connected by first and last ends of polygons here. Remember that the relation of constructing Bezier curve, the first and last points of curve is coincide with polygon first and end points of B0 curve. That means P0, P3 are the first and last points of curve, and those are coincide with polygon first and last points P1, P2. P0 is mixed with P1, P3 is coincide with P2. By using this path, we are using to generate Bezier curve. Degree of polynomial is less than 1 here. Next, the curve is contained within the convex hull of the defining polygon. The representation for Bezier curve is P of u equal to sigma I equal to 0 pi bi n of u. That is the representation. Students, please remember those equations. Those are very important. Sigma I equal to 0 to n pi bi n of u. N is the segment for each polygon. N plus 1 is the vertices for each polygon and number of control points. That is description for Bezier curve. When comes to Bernstein polynomial, BI in previous slide, we write here P of u equal to sigma I equal to 0 to n pi. BI n of u is the Bernstein polynomial. For that reason, I am explaining here Bernstein polynomial BI n of u equal to n factorial by I factorial of n minus I factorial ui into 1 minus u of n minus I. Here, bi n of u is a function of the number of curve segments n. For n equal to 2, the equation will be n factorial by I of n minus I factorial. For n equal to 0, n is always 2, I is changed for equation to equation. N equal to 2, 2 factorial by I equal to 0 here, 2 minus I means 0. 2 factorial by 2 factorial. 2 factorial means 2 into 1 by 2 into 1. 2 by 2, that equal to 1. For n equal to 2, I equal to 1. 2 factorial by 1 factorial into 2 minus 1 factorial. That means 2 factorial by 1 factorial into 1 factorial. 2 into 1, 2. For n equal to 2, I equal to 2. That will be 1. That is the Bernstein polynomial. It is also very important for 2 marks questions. Write the expression for Bernstein polynomial. That will be bi n of u equal to n factorial by I factorial of n minus I factorial. That is very much important equation. Next properties of Bezier curve. In previous slide, we discuss about advantages and disadvantages of Hermite cubic plane. In this slide, we are discussing about properties of Bezier curve. The Bezier curve starts from P0 and ends to Pn point. This is known as endpoint interpolation property. Okay. Next, the Bezier curve is a straight line when all the control points of curve are collinear. That means Bezier curve is always in straight line positions. For that reason, those are coincide with first and last points. The beginning of the Bezier curve is tangent to the first portion of the Bezier polygon. Bezier curve can be divided at any point into two subcurves. That means each of which is also Bezier curve. That will be discussed in previous slide. So I am showing to you. In that section, in first section, I am showing that it will be in this section, it will be cut in middle section. So based on P0 and P1 point, it is also a Bezier curve. At down section, P0 and P1, at top section, P2 and P3, two subcurves. One Bezier curve will be divided into two segments. those two are related to Beezerkers. That is the property of Beezerker. Next, classifications of Beezerker: simple Beezerker, quadratic Beezerker, cubic Beezerker. The order of Beezerker is a function of the number of control points. Four control points n equal to 3 always produce a cubic Beezerker. That means based on control points we are generating Beezerkers here. In first simple Beezerker, I'm taking two control points here, P0 and P1. At middle point, I'm showing simple Beezerker here. Based on four control points, I'm drawing cubic Beezerker. In third figure, I'm showing P0, P1, P1 dash and P0 dash. Those are the different types of Beezerkers. Next, B-spline curve. It is similar to Beezerker, but what is the difference and what is the similarities to B-spline to the Beezerker? It provides local control of the curve shape. In Beezerker, local control is not handled in Beezerker. When it comes to B-spline curve, it provides local control of the curve shape. In B-spline curve, we have the ability to interpolate or approximate to set of given data points. In B-spline curve, we are defining or in B-spline curve involves more information like n plus 1 and m plus 1 nodes. N plus 1 is related to control points, M plus 1 is related to node vectors, and degree P. The representation for B-spline curve is P of U equal to sigma I equal to 0 to N, Pi Ni, comma K of U. 0 less than or equal to U, less than or equal to U max. That is very important equation for B-spline curve representation. P of U equal to sigma I equal to 0 to N, Pi Ni K of U. That is B-spline curve representation. Ni K of U is the B-spline basis function. In Beezerker, Bn of U is the Bernstein polynomial. In B-spline curve, Ni K of U is the B-spline basis function of degree P. In this more information like n plus 1 and m plus 1, degree P. N plus 1 are related to control points. Those are from P0 to Pn and node vector starting from U0 to Um. And B-spline curve of degree P defined by these control points and vectors, node vectors. Next, properties of B-spline curve. Here I'm showing different types of B-spline curves here. The degree of Bezier basis function depends on the number of control points. Here also same similarities to Bezier to B-spline curve. In Bezier curve also, we are discussing about the Bezier curve is generated by using of control points. In B-spline also, we are depending on control points. Next, to change the shape of B-spline curve, one can modify one or more of these control parameters. Okay, at any point we can change the shape of B-spline curve. Control points and nodes means U0, U1 to Um. Another degree of curve means P. Next, here I am showing local control of B-spline curve. What is the difference between BZR2 beast plant curve based on local control of beast plant curves. The first property ensures that the relation between the curve and the defining control points is invariant under transformations. The second property guarantees that curve segment lies completely within convex hull of PIR. First of all, what is convex hull? Okay, it will be discussed in later slides. In this, I am discussing about first property, second property, third properties here. It is useful to notice the Bernstein. In previous slide, we discussed about Bernstein on a BAN of U equal to N factorial by I factorial into N minus I factorial. The relation for Bernstein polynomial has the same first two properties mentioned above. Okay. Next, in previous class we discussed about solid modeling techniques. Those are constructive solid geometry and boundary representation. In this slide, we are discussing about surface modeling techniques. First, surface patch, and second one is the Kuhn's patch and bicubic patch. First of all, I am discussing about surface patch. Surface patch. This patch is used for building of black for surfaces. Surface patch is based on two variables like U and V. This surface patch can be changed by using of U and V variables ranging from 0 to 1. This range, this is called as a biparametric surface patch. After then fixing of the value of one of the parametric variables results in a curve on the patch in terms of other variables. That is called as isoparametric curve. Okay, first one is the figure for surface patch. Surface patch can be changed by using of two parametric variables U and V. One is in horizontal direction, one is in vertical vector direction. In horizontal direction, surface patch can be changed only in horizontal directions. By using of V parameter, it can be changed like vector or vertical directions. Next, Kuhn's patch. In Kuhn's patch, interpolation across intersecting mesh of curves, it will be like this. Kuhn's patch can be, it is a sculptured surface, it will be generated by using of interpolating of curves, by using of interpolating of curves at all points, by using of meshing of curves that in effect of comprising a rectangular grid of patches. Here I am showing rectangular grids here from P00 to P01, P11 to P10. Here, the boundary curves Ci of U and Dj of V, and the corner points are Pij of the patch. Expression for Kuhn's patch, P of U, V equal to C0 of U, Fv plus C1 of U, Zv plus D0 of V, F of U plus D1 of V, Z of U. Linear blending has limitations and higher order blending functions such as cubics are used here. What is the difference between surface patch to Kuhn's patch here? Because the difference between surface patch to Kuhn's patch, surface patch can be used for building of blocks for surfaces. It can be generated by using of two very parametric variables U and V. When it comes to Kuhn's patch, it will be depend upon sculptural surface of interpolating all mesh points. It will be changed by using of meshing points at each boundary curves. Finally, bicubic patch. The bicubic patch is used for surface descriptions defined in terms of point and tangent vector. Bicubic patch is defined by using of terms of point and tangent vector information. The representation for bicubic patch P of u comma v equal to sigma I equal to 0 to 3, sigma j equal to 0 to 3, kij ui vj. That is the representation for bicubic patch. Here 16 unknown parameters for kij, which can be found by using Lagrangian interpolation function. Left-handed Bezier bicubic patch, right-handed Bezier bicubic patch. Today with this class, second unit completed. In next class, we will discuss about unit 3. Unit 3 is numerical control. In numerical control, we will discuss about DNC and CNC, adaptive programmings, etc. CNC programmings, different types of CNC programmings are there. Okay.